Good morning, student. Welcome back to Digital Electronic class. In the today's class, we are going to continue the code converter concept, in which what we discussed till now, we discuss about the conversion of the code from your BCD codes to your XS3. That part we covered in the previous class. In today's class, the same concept we are going to continue, but some other way of conversions. So in that, we are going to see the first today's class, we are going to see BCD to 7 segment. 7 segment code conversion. So this part we are going to discuss in today's class. So basically, what is this 7 segment and what is a BCD code actually? So we know that BCD codes are nothing but the digits which we do have. So BCD code consists of the numbers from 0 to 9, right? The 7 segments, what is the 7 segments? So segments are nothing but we do have this, these are our digital digits, right? So these are 7 segments. So one, this is your A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So these are our nothing but our segments. So in that, we are taking the BCD codes and we just want to convert into 7 segment. That conversion of the codes we are going to discuss in today's class. So basically, how do we do it? In order to do these things, we need to see how many segments it consists of. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Total 7 segments it has. Next thing, by taking the BCD code, each segments will give respective value and we try to convert into its equivalent binary function. So basically what we are doing, we are taking the digital numbers in that particular format from 0 to 9. Those numbers, each segments are consist of a specific digit. So that digits we just want to take it and we'll try to write that code of it. How do the code can be generated? It can have hexa code, it can have different types of codes, which already we discussed in the previous classes. So in today's class, we are going to continue with the same concept of BCD codes. In that, we are going to take these particular digits in all the format, and those digits we just want to convert into its binary equivalent values for it. So for that, what we'll do it, it has from, what are the values it can have? It can have first 0, right? This is a 0. Next, how do we get 1? This is your 1 digit. Digital I'm saying. So this is 1. How, what about 2? This is your 2. Likewise, I can get the 3. So I do have next is 3. Next I can go get with 4. This is my 4 digit. Likewise I can have 5. So this is my 5 digit. Like I can get the 6. So how do I get the 6? This is my 6, right? Likewise I can get till 9, right? 6. The next would be 7. This is my 7 digit. How do I get 8? This is my 8, right? How do I get 9? This is my 9. So these are digits I do have. These are nothing but your digital. Whenever we see any kind of electronic gadgets or anything, we are getting these types of digits, right? So how do we get those digits? How do these digits can have the specific value? So that thing we are going to do in terms of conversion of the codes with each segment. So that part in today's class we are going to cover. So let us see how do we convert that digits and its equivalent value. That we will see in today's class. So basically what we are taking, these all digits and we'll try to write that digit into a specific code value by taking the each segment. Since it has how many segments? It has 7 segments. So basically we just want to go with all types of 7 segments. So what we will take? We will take first, we will try to make one tabular form. So by taking all the different types of digits and we will try to write its value. So what I'm doing, I'm writing this segments and its respective value. So suppose this is my segments I'm writing, first column I'm making for segment. So first column we are preparing for the given digit segment. So what is the first digit we do have? We do have first is 0. Next, I can get with 1. Next, I can get with 2. Next, I can go with 3. So likewise, I'm taking these digits. So basically, we know that we are segregating into 7 segments. A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. So this is nothing but our digital numbers. Now next we are writing the segments. How many segments has? 7 segments. So we write A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Right? We prepare one column. So in that what we'll write? We'll write the respective value for each segments. How do we get this particular value for that particular segment? So what is the first one? I want to get 0. How do I get 0? A should be there. B, C, D, E, and F. Do we need G? G is not required. So that means G is 0, remaining is 1. So remaining is high. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and this is 0. Likewise, I want to enable digit 1. So how do I get? B and C should be high, remaining will be low. So because this is B, right? This is C. So B and C will be high, remaining all digits will be low. So this way we'll go with 1. Likewise, I can go with 2. So I do have A, B is there, G is required, E is required, and D, right? So basically, don't write this thing for your explanation. Beside I wrote it. Don't mention ABCD in that. Okay. So what we do have A, B, E, D. A is required. B, C is not required. D is there. Yes, E is there. Next, E, then F is not there. Then G is required. Right? So we wrote that binary form. Likewise, I go on with 3. How do we get the 3? A should be there. B, A, B, then G must be present, then C, then D. So these digits must be high, remaining will be low. For that, what I am writing? I am writing A, B, C, D, right? E is not required, F is not required, G is required. Clear? So likewise, I can go with remaining all digits. I can go with next part. What I do have next thing? After 3, next is 4. Next is 5. Likewise, I can get with 6. Next, I can go with 7. Then 8. Then 9. Okay, so this is the way we are mentioning digital numbers. So these digital numbers we mentioned. This is make second column. So these are nothing but again digital numbers. And next would be what? Segment A, B, C, D. So these segments we will write, and we'll try to write the respective value for it. So for that, what we are doing? We are writing the segments. So we will write respective segment for it. So till now we done with 0, 1, 2, 3. Next thing, we just want to write the remaining digital numbers. So for that, what we are writing? We are writing the segments of that particular thing, and we'll try to write down those values. For that, what we will do? We will write the codes of it. Okay, so what we did, we wrote all the numbers with respect to their codes. So we do have segments A, B, C, D, E, F, and G, right? So these are our segments. So now we need to get 4. How do we get 4? For doing this thing, you should remember this particular thing. What is that? A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So these are the segments we do have. To get 4, what is required? F is required. Yes, F is high. Next thing, this column. This is nothing but B. B is required. Yes, B is 1. Next, G is required. G is 1. G, this part is done. Next, C is required. C is 1. What about A? A we don't require. So this is 0, 0, and 0. Clear? So by seeing these segments, we need to write it down the value. Now, go to get the 5. What is required? A, F, G, then C, then D. This much is required. For that, what I'll write? A is 1, then C is 1, B is 0, D is 1, F is 1, G is 1. This is 0, right? So we had A, F, G, C, D. So these are the things we required. So we wrote it down, that particular segments with high. Whatever that is not required, that we could put it as 0. So that is done. Next, you just want to get the 6. So to get 6, only B is not required, right? Remaining all are there. So for that, what I'll write? B is 0, remaining all are 1. This is about 6. To get 7, we required A, B, and C. That's it. So A, B, C, remaining all are 0. Like to get the 7 done. To get the 8, all should be required, because all should be enabled. Then only 8 digits will be appeared. So for that, what I'll write? All should be 1s to get 8. To get 9, what is required? To get 9, I don't have to get this segment. What is that segment number? E. So we don't require E. So what is E? E is 0. Remaining all is high. Clear? So this is the way we done your 7 segment code, that into the BCD code, that by taking that binary complete binary formation. Now for each code, what we'll require? We require the hex code we required. For that, what we will do? We'll try to combine that particular code into the values of it. So in order to do that, what we will do? We will write the hex code for each number. Clear? So till now what we did, students? So we talk about the BCD code. BCD codes are the numbers or digits which are varying from 0 to 9. Then each digits or segment, we just given a specific letter A, B, C, D. We took it for 7 segment. Then what we did, we'll write down that particular binary combination for each digits, starting from 0 digit to 9 digit. After getting that digit, we just want to write that hexadecimal codes. So for that, we need to write that particular code and we will write that particular function. So this is the things we do have in code conversion. So now what is left out? We have to write the code of it. So how do I get the code? I can combine this 4. I don't have one more. So what I'll do, I'll append that particular thing into 0. So we don't have the 8 combination. For that, what I'm doing, I'm just having this one. I don't have the 3 digits only there. For hex code, what is required? There should be 4 binary inputs, right? 4 input value should be there, then only we can write the hexadecimal code. But we don't have in this. What we will do, we'll try to write 0 for it. So for that, I'll show you how do we get the code, hexadecimal code, for these particular 7 segment digits. So students, so we just want to write the particular code for it. For that, what we are writing, we know this binary combination. Now next thing, what we are writing the hexadecimal code, right? For that, what we will do, we will write that 0. So what we got for 0, all ones, last we got it as 1 1 0. Okay, so we got this. So 1 1 1 and 1 1 1 0. For that, this I can write it as F, right, in hexadecimal. What about this? I don't have the one more number. So what I'm doing, I'm writing 0 for it. So what I'll get? 8 plus 4. 8 plus 4 is 12. What is 8 plus 4, 12 value? A is 10, B is 11, C is 12. So I can write C in hexadecimal. Hexadecimal is base 16. Similarly, what is this value? 4 plus 2 is 6. We don't have one more digit. So I'm writing 0 here. So what I get? 60 in hexadecimal or base 16. Right, for the next one, for getting this 2, what I'll write, this is nothing but 8 plus 4. 8 plus 4 is 12. 12 plus 1, 13. 13 is D. So this is D. I'll put 0 again here so that I can get 4 hexadecimal. Since it is 7 segments, so we required one more digit for that. For that particular thing, what I'm doing, I'm getting as 0. That is nothing but ground. Clear? So what I'll write, so 8 plus 2. 8 plus 2 is 10. That is nothing but A. DA with base 16. Next, for 3, it's F, put a 0 here, it's 2, F2 in base 16, similarly to get 4, so this is nothing but 4 plus 2, 6, 6, again this is 6, 6 and 6 with base 16, these are the respective value for that particular digits, clear? So now thing is that we just want to get 5, so put a 0 here, so how do we get this thing? 8 plus 2, 10, 11. So 11 is B. This is 6. So B is 6 with base 16. Similarly, to get 6, so this is nothing but 8 plus 2 plus 1. 11. So how do we get 11? B is there, it's 11. Likewise, I can put a 0 here. So this is nothing but E. E is 14. So I can write for this E with base 16. Similarly, for 7. What is the 7 value you can write? 8 plus 2 plus 4, that is 14, right? 8 plus 4 is 12, 12 plus 2 is 14. 14 is nothing but E. E, this is 0, with base 16. Clear? So we got this thing. Now left out is 7, after that, 8. How do we get 8? So here only we do have 8 and here only we do have 9. Okay, so for 8, what we are writing, all digits is enable. So that digits, what is the value we do have? We had here 8, right? So what is 8 value we do have? 8 digits. If you want to write, all is 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. These are 7 segments. So I'm writing 0 for it. This is your F, this is your E. So I can write FE with base 16, right? Likewise, I want to get with 9. So 9 is what? So 1 1 1 1, this is 0 1 1, there is no number means 0, we add. So what I'll get? F6 with base 16. So that's how we got that digit in binary form, then we wrote it in hexadecimal form. This is the way your 7 segment digits has been converted into that particular BCD codes. Then we convert into a hexadecimal value. So this is the way we will proceed with code conversions. Clear? For that, you need to note down this ABCD values, and then you need to write it down that respective combination for it. Note it down this particular codes of 0 to 9 digits and even its hexadecimal value. So students, so to write those digits, we wrote it the conversion. So what actually the codes will be there? These digits are actually nothing but when we had a combinational circuitry in that code conversion, if you want to do it, your digits are, what are the digits we do have? Suppose this is complete 7 segment digits. So in that, whatever the digits we are giving, that it will do it, and after that it will try to produce its respective value for it. So because of these 7 segments, how many segments you have? You have A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. So this can be designed in two methods. One is the common cathode and common anode method. That part of it you will be having in microprocessor. Microprocessor and interfacing, you will be having the subject. In that, you are learning the interfacing of this one with microprocessor kit. So because of these combination of that code, how do we get zero digit? So internally, when you want to get this zero digit, so internally this understanding of that particular electronic device, electronic appliances or any gadget is there, internally they do have this FC code inside it. That means whatever the number we just want to display, like you had the scientific calculator, in that you will make, you are getting these kind of codes. So these code, these digital display numbers you do have, that one internally they do have this particular code internally, in that then it is going to generate that code for it. For that the reason we can write those things into that respective code combination, and then we'll try to produce the output for it. For that purpose, this code conversions has been used in all kind of digital circuitry where the binary digits zeros and ones we are converting into respective number systems. We do have the number systems from your binary, your hexadecimal, your decimal, your octal. So you have various types of number systems. In that, we are going to use this particular code and we just want to produce the output for it. So in this, it can design by using common cathode, common anode. In that, if it is common anode method or common cathode method, how do we design? That each designing part will be using a specific segment by one diode. They will take it and they will design this part. Clear? So this is the things we just in the digital electronics will be having only the conversions. We don't have this complete designing part. That's the reason I'm not showing you how this designing has been there and what is this each device is consist of. That particular thing you will be having maybe in your basic electronics, or it is there in microprocessor and interfacing, that you will come to know in the upcoming semester. Okay, so this is about the code conversion. So what we discuss into code conversion, we discuss that whatever the codes we do have, BCD codes, we try to convert into the hexa code, or we just want to write that equivalent value of that 7 segments starting from the display of 0 to display of 9. So those displays, if you want to write down, that display can be used and can be designed and can be make the designing of it by taking this particular code or by taking this combination of the binary. So each one, what is that? This is nothing but A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Like this we do have, right? So this is our 7 segments. What we are adding for each digits, we are adding this 0. This is our extra thing what we are adding for all the digits. Even in this also we added so that we can get the respective hex code, because hex code should be consist of 4-4 binary combination. For that the reason we just add the 0. So and we got this particular hexadecimal code for each segments. So this is the way we have proceed for code conversions. So in next upcoming classes, we are going to proceed with sequential circuitry. And before that, we do have this programmable logical devices, PLA and PAL. These two topics and the more of it, that particular thing, we are going to discuss in next class. So this is about the today's class. And make a notes of it and try to note down this particular thing. It's quite easy if you make the running notes on the time itself. If you try to do at the end after watching the complete video, it has become hectic and it's become very complex to take all the things. So whenever we do have a class, try to make it the notes of it, and then it will be easy for you to understand. Thank you.